Hello friends, in this video we are going to study about the working of the relay to block the power swings. So basically, when the fault is cleared by the circuit breaker, some amount of disturbances take place due to which power swings occur. So in this video, we are going to study about the power swing blocking relays. Before studying the power swing blocking relay, let us study the effect of power surges on the performance of the transmission line. So let us consider the diagram A, in which transmission line connecting the two generating stations are shown. So figure shows the single line diagram to illustrate the loss of synchronism in the system. Here if we see, the line is connected between two generators A and B. Then this is the generated voltage EA for the generator A. EB is the generator voltage for the generator B. Then ZA is the impedance for the generator station A. ZB is the impedance for the B. Similarly, relays are connected. Then ZL is the line impedance. So the current which is flowing through the transmission line basically depends upon phase difference between the voltage generated at the two ends of the line. So whatever current is transmitted through the transmission line will depend upon the generated voltage, that is EA and EB in this case. Now this phase difference is basically equal to the rotor angle. The phase difference between generated voltage will change due to the disturbance. Now this disturbance is caused when the circuit breaker clears the fault. So whenever the circuit breaker clears the fault, there is a huge amount of power swing. Due to this power swing, there is a disturbance between the rotor angle and its value will change. So these disturbances arrive due to the removal of fault or sudden change of the load. Now during the disturbances, rotor of the generator will swing around the final steady state value. So when the rotor will swing during the power surge condition, then the rotor angle changes, and as a result of this, the current which is flowing through the line also changes, because the current which is flowing through the line depends upon the phase difference between the value of the generated voltages at the sending end generator and the receiving end generator. This value depends upon the rotor angle. As the rotor angle changes, the current in the transmission line will also change. So such heavy currents are known as power surges. So when the rotor angle changes and there is a change in the transmission line current, then the value of this current is very heavy. So such heavy currents are basically called as power surges. So as long as the phase angle between the generated voltage goes on changing, the current sensed by the relay also keeps on changing. So as the phase angle of the generator is changing, the relay will also sense the change in current. So relay might think that it is a fault condition because the current will keep changing accordingly. Therefore, the impedance measured by the relay will vary during the power swings. Now we know that in case of distance relay, the distance relay operates when the value of impedance drops below the particular value. So basically, this change in value will be sensed by the impedance. As there is a condition of the continuous power swings, the impedance will also keep on changing. So relay will not be able to decide whether it is a normal condition or it is the faulty condition. Therefore, the power surge sensed by the relay appears as the fault which is changing its distance from relay location. Now as the impedance is changing, the relay will also think that the location of fault is changing with respect to the relay location. So let us consider the characteristic of some important distance relays and the power surges which are shown on the RX diagram as shown in figure B. So here the figure shows the effect of power surges on the distance relay. We know that the distance relay characteristic is better represented on the RX diagram. So the figure shows RX diagram. In case of distance relay operation, the distance up to which the relay will provide the protection depends upon the radius of the RX diagram. Now, when the fault occurs, it's between this radius, the relay operates. If the fault goes beyond the radius of the circle, the relay remains inoperative. So let us study the characteristic of various types of distance relays which are shown in the diagram. So here we have the starting unit for the reactance relay. Then these are the power surges which are indicated. Then this is the directional unit for the impedance relay. Again here we have the characteristic for Mo relay. Then we have the characteristic of reactance relay. Again we have the characteristic of impedance relay. If we see the diagram, we can see that the location occupied by the Mo relay is less as compared to impedance relay and reactance relay. So we can see from the figure that it is evident that the relay characteristic occupying the greater area on the RX diagram will remain under the influence of the power surges. Whichever relay out of the three distance relays, that is impedance relay, reactance relay and Mo relay, will occupy more area in the characteristic, that relay will be influenced more by the power surges. So from the figure we can see that Mo relay is having the least area on the RX diagram. As a result, it will be least affected by the power surges. Then the impedance relay characteristic has more area than the Mo relay, but the lesser area than the reactance relay. So obviously, impedance relay will be affected more than the Mo relay by the power surges, but not as much as the reactance relay. Therefore, while it is affected more than the Mo relay, it is less affected than the reactance relay. In other words, we can say that it is moderately affected. That is, it is more affected than the Mo relay, but less affected than the reactance relay. Now, the reactance relay is occupying the largest area and hence it is most affected. Now, let us study the analysis of the power swing. So, the figure shows the section of the transmission line with the generating station beyond the either ends. So, the generated voltages are EN and EB respectively. The voltage at the relay location is denoted by V. So the impedances are also shown in figure. Let us see this in the diagram. So the figure shows the connection between two generating stations A and B. Here EA and EB are the respective generated voltages. Then ZA and ZB are the respective impedances. Then ZL is the line impedance. V is the voltage of the relay. So from this figure, the current flowing through the line can be derived as I is equal to EA minus EB divided by ZA plus ZL plus ZB, where EA is equal to generated voltage at generator A, then EB is equal to generated voltage at generator B. Similarly, ZA is equal to impedance of A, then ZB is equal to impedance at B. Similarly, ZL is equal to line impedance. We can further modify the equation for the current as I is equal to EA minus EB divided by ZT, where ZT is equal to ZA plus ZL plus ZB. Now, if we take the term ZT on that side of equation, we can modify the above equation as I multiplied by ZT is equal to EA minus EB. Now, I multiplied by Z is nothing but voltage. Hence, we can modify above equation as V is equal to I multiplied by ZT. Hence, substituting IZT by V, we get V is equal to EA minus EB. Now, again, we can write the formula for EB as EB is equal to I multiplied by ZA. So, substituting the value of EB in the above equation, we get V is equal to EA minus I into ZA. Now, the impedance that is seen by the relay or sensed by the relay can be written as Z is equal to V divided by I. So, substituting the formula for V in this equation, we get Z is equal to EA minus I multiplied by ZA divided by I. Now, dividing each term separately by the current I, we can modify above equation as V is equal to EA divided by I minus IZA divided by I. Now, in this term, I in the numerator and denominator will get cancelled. Hence, we can write Z is equal to EA divided by I minus ZA. We can further modify this equation as we know that formula for the I can be written as I is equal to EA minus EB divided by ZT. So, substituting this formula of I, we get Z is equal to EA divided by EA minus EB divided by ZT minus ZA. Now, further simplifying this equation, we get Z is equal to EA multiplied by ZT divided by EA minus EB minus ZA. Now, if we consider that EA is leading EB by an angle del, then we can write also if EA by EB is equal to N, then we can modify above equation as Z is equal to NE raised to I del divided by NE raised to I del minus I multiplied by ZT minus ZA. Now, this above equation represents the family of circle with N as a parameter and del as the variable, which is as shown in figure C. Now, if you consider that n is equal to 1, then the power swing is the locus. Now, if you consider that n is equal to 1, then the power swing locus is a straight line perpendicular to AB. So, here this is the line AB. So, here we have the line that is the power swing, which is perpendicular to AB. at the instant n is equal to 1. Also, the value of AB is equal to ZT. That is the total impedance of the line. Now, if n is greater than 1 or n is less than 1, the power swing loci are circles as shown in figure C. So, here we have the circumference or a curve for n is less than 1. Similarly, here we have the circumference of the circle for n greater than 1. So, if n is greater than 1, then the locus is the circle. Now, the center of the circle lie on the extension of the line ZT as shown in figure D. So, here if we see, this is also the RX diagram. This is our point AB. Then, this is the center of the circle. So, the center of circle lies on the extension of AB. Now, AB is equal to ZT. Now, if you consider that n is greater than 1, then the distance from B to the center of the circle is given by ZT divided by n square minus 1. So, here it is represented ZT divided by n square minus 1. This is for the value of n greater than 1. Similarly, the radius of circle is given by nzt divided by n square minus 1. Again, it is represented here. This is the radius of the circle. So, both these values are as shown in figure D. Now, if you consider that n is less than 1, then in this case, the circles are symmetrical to those for the n greater than 1, but their centers are beyond A as shown in figure B. Let us see this in the diagram. So, if we see this diagram, for the value n is greater than 1 or n is less than the 1, both the circles are represented. Also, we have seen that both the circles are symmetrical. Then the same formula can be used for the radius and the distance of the center by substituting 1 by n in place of n. So, as long as the power swing locus will remain in the characteristic zone of the distance relay, on the RX diagram, the relay will sense a fault and it will have the tendency to trip. Whether the relay will trip or not, it will depend on the period for which the swing locus influences the relay characteristic. Now, due to the presence of the power swing, certain amount of impedance is exerted on the relay characteristic. So, as long as this point is within the reach of the relay will consider it as a faulty condition and the relay will have tendency of tripping. Now, let us study about out-of-step tripping and blocking relays. So, when the generator of the power system loses its synchronism, all the ties between them are opened to maintain the supply and to resynchronize them. So, whenever there is a loss of synchronism between the generator, it is very necessary that the synchronism should be reinstated. For this, all the ties are broken and the procedures are carried out for the resynchronization. The separation of the system can be made at a certain selected location so that generator capacity and the loads on the either side of the point of separation are properly matched to maintain the supply. So, whenever the generators are taken out of the supply, then the supply to the consumer should not be interrupted. So, this is the special care which has to be taken. So, the figure shows the simple case of the two interconnected power stations. So, the figure shows the diagram for the two interconnected system with out-of-step tripping relay at the point 4. So, here we have two generators A and B. The capacity of A is 200 megawatt, whereas the capacity of B is 100 megawatt. Then, six relays are present, each having the capacity of 50 megawatt. Then the out-top step tripping relay is installed at location 4. So the section A has a generating capacity of 200 megawatt. It can supply the loads up to 4 points, that is 1, 2, 3 and 4. Section B has a generating capacity of 100 watt. So it can supply the load at 5 and 6 points. Let us see this in the figure. So if we see, the total generating capacity of section A is 200 megawatt. The generating capacity of each point is 50 megawatt. So if we divide 200 by 50, we get the 4 locations. So the section A can give power up to 4. Similarly, section B has a generating capacity of 100 megawatt. Now if we divide it by 50, again we get 2 locations. Hence section B provide to the load points 5 and 6. So if in this case the system will lose its synchronism, there should be a relaying equipment at point 4 for separation and resynchronization, because point 4 is present at the boundary of A and B. So if the condition arises for the loss of synchronism between section A and B, then there should be the relay present at the location 4 to sense this condition and provide the resynchronization. So the out-of-step relays are used at this point for the separation of the system. So the out-of-step relay is located at the location 4. All the other stations, the out-of-step blocking relays are used to prevent the tripping of the distance relay due to the power swings. Now when the two generators will lose their synchronism, then there will be tremendous amount of power swings. So this relay will prevent the operation of the distance relay for the power swing condition. Now let us study the principle of out-of-step blocking relay. So the diagram shows offset three zone characteristic for the power swing blocking. So when the fault occurs on the system, the voltage, current and the phase angle will change instantly. Whereas during the power swings, this quantity changes more slowly. This fact is utilized to cause the blocking of the distance relay on the power swings without preventing the tripping under the fault condition. Now the power swing is not considered to be a fault condition. So the relay should remain inoperative in case of power swing. Now we know that when the fault occurs, the value of current, voltage and the phase angle between them changes very rapidly due to the faulty condition. But in case of the power swing, this value changes, but the rate of change is very slow. So the same principle is used in the power swing blocking relay. Now in the more distance scheme, 1 and 2 units are more relay, whereas 3 unit is an offset more relay as shown in figure F. So here if we see, M1 and M2 are the more relay, whereas OM3 is the offset more relay. Now let us consider the condition of the power swing. So during the power swing, the 3 zone unit, that is OM3, operates before the zone 2 and zone 1 unit. See here, we have two units, M1 and M2. So M1 is a unit for zone 1, whereas M2 is a unit for zone 2. Both these units have the relay, that is a more relay. But the relay at the third zone, that is OM3, is the offset more relay. So when the power swing condition occurs, this relay will operate first. So OM3 will pick up the blocking relay B with the small time delay. So the figure F shows the connection of the blocking relay. So this is the basic connection of the out-of-step blocking relay. Here we have relay B, then we have M1 and M2. Then this is our out-of-step blocking relay M3. Then there is one timing unit. So the blocking relay B will open the contact B so that operation of the relay M2 is prevented during the power swing. Let us see this in the diagram. So when the power swing condition will occur at that time, B will open the contacts. As a result, M1 and M2 will be disconnected from the circuit. As a result, OM3 will operate, which will block the power swings. Now suppose there is a case of the fault, then in that case, M2 operates first and will trip the circuit breaker. Now a fault may occur during a swung and it must be cleared. Now wherever there is a power swing, there is a possibility of the occurrence of the fault. So this fault must also be cleared. So this will be cleared by M1 and M2. From such consideration, OM3 is not blocked and it takes care of such a case. Now let us study the principle of out-of-step tripping. Two blinders, that is angle impedance relays, are employed for the out-of-step tripping as shown in figure G. Also an auxiliary relay is used with each blinder. Also an auxiliary relay is used with each blinder. Now these blinders are arranged to cause the operation of one of the auxiliary relay if the impedance crosses the operating characteristic of one of them before the other in either direction. So the auxiliary relay can send signal to an alarm or trip a circuit or initiate some other form of control. So this is the basic function of the auxiliary relay. So in this way we have studied the power swing blocking relay. So basically, when the generators lose the synchronism, the rotor angle will change. This will cause the power swings. Now, in order to block the power swing blocking relay is used. Thank you friends for watching this video. Stay tuned with eKida and do subscribe our channel eKida. Thank you.